गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, आई एम प्रतिभा रिजाल और टीचर ट्रेनी ऑफ सिलीगुड़ी तराई बीएड कॉलेज एंड सिलीगुड़ी प्राइमरी टीचर्स ट्रेनिंग कॉलेज. सो टुडे हियर आई एम इज टू टीच यू अ चैप्टर फ्रॉम हिस्ट्री विच इज़ ऑफ वेस्ट बंगाल बोर्ड क्लास 10. ओके, द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज रेजिस्टेंस एंड रेबेलियन. ओके, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड दिस चैप्टर in the last class, let's revise what we read in the last class. Okay, in the last class we came to know about two rebellion, and those were the Kol rebellion and the Santhal rebellion. Okay, in Kol rebellion the tribal people was mostly affected by the British people, and they thought of revolting against the British government. Not only that, they also fought. They not only fought alone, they were joined by several other tribes like Hos, Munda, Gond and others. Okay, they proudly fought with their traditional equipments with the British government, who were fighting with their modern equipments. Okay, then we read about another rebellion, that was the Santhal rebellion. These Santhals were the people who used to live in peace. They used to love peace, but their peace was destroyed by the British government. So they thought of revolting against the British government. And here we also came to know that Santhal rebellion proved to be successful, as the British government was forced to create a separate district for the Santhal people. Okay. This is what we read in the last class, and for today we will learn another subtopic, and that is Sanyasi and the Fakir rebellion. Okay, Sanyasi and the Fakir rebellion, it happened in between 1763 to 1800. Okay, Sanyasis and Fakir was also a part of India. Okay, Sanyasi and Fakir are also part of India. Both of them used to live during those time. Both of them used to live on a charitable gifts, which means that these Sanyasis and Fakir people used to move from place to place in search of peace, and they used to earn their livelihood by whatever other people used to offer them. Whatever other people used to offer them, they used to eat that and used to meditate whole day and night. Okay, these are the Sanyasis and Fakir people. Okay, now how these people revolted? Okay, Majnu Saha was the leader for Fakirs. Majnu Saha was the leader for Fakirs, whereas Bhawani Pathak was the leader for Sanyasis. Okay, these two thought of organizing some revolt against the British government, as the British government has destroyed their peace in various ways, various types. Okay, now there were many causes because of which they revolted against the British. Okay, number one cause was the British government imposed a ban in the movement of the Sanyasis and Fakirs. Okay, these Sanyasis people used to travel from one place to another in search of peace, but what the British government did was that they imposed ban on these movement of Sanyasis and Fakirs. Okay, this was the number one cause for them to organize a revolt against British government. Okay, now the second was the variety of pilgrimage tax was implied to the Sanyasis and the Fakir people. Okay, these Sanyasis and Fakir people who used to earn their livelihood by whatever other people used to give them, but they were also made to pay the pilgrimage tax. Okay, this was the second reason for them to organize a revolt against British government. Okay, now the third reason was that the British government always used to interfere with their affair, with the affairs of the Sanyasi and Fakir. Okay, British government never left them alone, as they always used to interfere in their matters. Okay, this was the main reason for them to organize the revolt against British government. Okay, while there are various opinions by some historians who says that these sannyasis and fakirs turned anti-rebellion, anti-British with their rebellion, but the detailed analysis of these revolt revealed that these sannyasis and fakir peoples mainly organized the revolt to fight the economic distress that was created by the Bengal famine in 1769 to 1770. Okay, this was the sannyasi and fakir rebellion. Now let's move on to another subtopic, that is Wahhabi and the Farizi movement. Okay, now what is this Wahhabi and Farizi movement? In this Wahhabi and Farizi movement, the peasants organized the revolt. Here the main people were the peasants, okay, who used to work as a agricultural laborer, who are the farmers. Okay, these were the people who organized this thing, this revolt. Okay, then what was the important feature of this Wahhabi and Farabi movement was that these two movements were totally a different movements, were two different movements, started from different state. Okay, but their ideologies and their concepts, their goal was same. Okay, their ideologies, their concepts and their goal was same in organizing the revolt. Okay, now let's read in detail what is a Wahhabi movement. Okay, the Wahhabi movement was started by Muhammad Abul Wahhab. This is the name of a person, Muhammad Abul Wahhab. He started a Wahhabi movement. Okay, and it used to be a pure religious movement. Okay, it was an Islamic movement started by Muhammad Abul Wahhab. And the main aim of this movement was to purify Islam, as they thought that their Islamic religion was overcome by some impurity. Okay, so they thought of purifying their religion by organizing this revolt. Okay, and as this revolt was started in Barasat, this revolt was successfully carried in Bengal also, and it was carried by Mir Nisar Ali, who was popularly known as Titu Mir, successfully carried this revolt in West Bengal as well. Okay, from the very beginning, Titu Mir directed his energy in organizing the peasants against the British agents like moneylenders, jamindars, indigo planters and so many other agents. Okay, Titu Mir made his energies on them. Okay, then what happened was that Titu Mir and his followers organized an armed resistance. Okay, armed resistance with that gola barud. They organized armed resistance against these jamindars in Pura. Pura is a name of a place. Okay, now what happened was that then the jamindars of the Pura was so much terrified by this attack from Titu Mir that they set the mosque into a fire. Okay, that they set the mosque of Wahhabis into fire. Then they, by some means, they made Titu Mir responsible for it. Okay, these jamindars set the mosque into fire, but what they did was they made Titu Mir responsible for it, for setting the mosque in fire. Okay, then Titu Mir wanted to revenge against it, and in revenge Titu Mir targeted all the oppressive jamindars. Okay, he targeted all the jamindars. Then he, Titu Mir, along with his 600 villagers, quickly, hurriedly built up a fortress named Bansar Killa. He built up a fortress named Bansar Killa with mud and bamboo. Okay, and with the help of that killa, he revenged against the British government. And this revolt was became so famous in history that it came to be known as Barasat Uprising of 1831. This revolt came to be known as Barasat Uprising of 1831. Okay, this much for today. Rest we will learn in the next class. And what we learned today is that, let's have a brief recapitulation. We learned that sannyasis and fakirs were the people who used to earn their livelihood by what other people used to give them. And they also organized the revolt against the British government because the British government imposed some taxes, pilgrimage taxes on them. They used to interfere on their matters. The British government banned their movement from one place to another. Then we came to know about the Wahhabi movement, in which Muhammad Abul Wahab was the leader of these movement. Whereas in Bengal, Mir Nisar Ali, popularly known as Titu Mir, was the leader of this movement, who built a fort named Banser Killa, through which he revenged against the British government. And these revolt became famous in history, which came to be known as Barasat Uprising of 1831. Okay, this much for today. Rest we will learn in the next class. Thank you.